Hello guys, I'm Vaterin or Spaßvogel or some call me just Vogel, but I think that's another story. In this guide I wanna talk about my spells. I wanna talk about all her builds and some talents, and I will show you some combos what you can do with her. Also I will show you some in-game clips in between so you will see good examples right away. I'm in the red team, a big team fight is happening. My team is losing this fight right now. But the enemies have everything on cooldown, that's why I decide to go in. Just in 4 people. And take out 3 of them. First, let's talk about the Q. It has just 4 second cooldown, that means you should spam it all the time for clearing minions, for poking your enemies and stuff like that. And it resets if you hit 2 targets or more. It is really important to get your multiple stacks, your multiple targets. That's why I highly recommend to go in try mode and just practice over here at these puppets. Of course do it while moving, otherwise it's too easy. And if this is still too easy for you and you're already good Maiev and are capable to use your Q well, then I recommend to go to these 2 puppets. You see there's a big gap in between, but you can also reset like this. It's much more difficult, and if you can reset like this in-game, then you are truly a bigger threat to the enemies. And wait, let me show it to you like this. You see the 2 ends of the Q will hit the targets just right and you will get your reset. So have fun with that. Then let's talk about the W. You see this circle? If you activate your W, your next auto attack is that circle and it bites everybody who is in that. That also means if an, I don't know, a minion or so is here and you hit the minion with your next auto attack with the W activated, then you bind everything who is nearby and pull to you, or for example behind this gate. If somebody's behind this gate and you hit the gate with your W active, you will pull the targets and stuff like that. And if you pull somebody, they're pretty much fucked, and it's super strong, this spell. Then let's talk about the E. So you know it travels this way, it turns around and comes back. You don't only have to use it at the end over here. I mean, sometimes you should if you chase somebody, or if you run away, or I don't know, if you teleport in 5 enemies and do your Maiev stuff. But in some other situations, one second, you can wait until it comes back and surprise your enemies. For example, you do stuff over here, you fight, and then bam, you're out. It's a really good technique and you should try it sometime, and it's working a lot of times. So then let's talk about the ultimates. First of all, you see here German words, but that's not what I want to talk about. Warden's Cage. It's super effective if you get much a lot of enemies inside, but you need damage behind you. You need damage from your team, like you need a mage, a Kel'Thas, a Jaina, and stuff like that. If you don't have that, if you just have Sylvanas or I don't know, somebody who's not dealing that much damage and not that much burst damage, you shouldn't go for that, because it won't give you that much value. You should try this one out. It's really good. It's much better than most of the people think. It has just 50 second cooldown and it's equal with Cocoon. Actually it's actually better than Cocoon, and you can do so much with that. Here's a good example for the single target ultimate. I see here Kerrigan, I instantly catch her with the ultimate like a Pokemon. I ping here for my team, then I just pull her to the right side. With that ultimate you can also catch the Dragonite, the Protector or the Terror, like this. The first build I want to talk about is the Auto Attack build or the Nysha's build. It's the most easy to play, but that don't mean that it's bad. It's actually it's pretty strong, but it's the most easy to play. First of all, of course you need Nysha's, then Blade Dance, then the W one, but I personally don't like that one that much, but you can go with that. It synergizes well with the auto attack build. And then I recommend for the auto attack build to go with the Q, because it's the most easy way to get your armor because you need to gain armor for the level 16 talent. If you gain armor, your 16 talent will give you increased physical damage. That also means it will increase the physical damage of the Q talent, of the Blade Dance talent. And then you also got Huntress, which will increase your auto attack speed and your movement speed. And everything synergizes just perfect. Then I can show it to you. First, I need to do a Q. Then I gain armor, then I activate Naishas and Huntress, and it kinda looks like this. You see the auto attacks are increased in damage, they spread, and yeah, all the good other stuff. It's highly effective, and you should play that if you just started to play Maiev. And then the E-build. You really shouldn't play that one, it's super shit. Now let's talk about the W build. First of all, you need this W talent on level 1, of course. Some people think that's bad because it's really difficult to stack, but it just needs practice. Then on level 4, I personally take Blade Dance, I tell you why later. I think that's really necessary. On level 7, I also go for the Q1, it's my personal favorite. I also go for that if I go for the auto attack build. Because a simple reason is the W talent, the W spell has 14 second cooldown and your Q has no cooldowns at all. Then on 13, most of the time I go for the E1. Sometimes I go for the Q1, it depends on how the game goes. And then on 20 I go for the second E, it synergizes with the 13. And yeah, I really recommend to you to try that one out. It's super OP. I mean, Maiev is already super OP, but yeah, this is just over the top. The last one here, this Shadow Strike, I think, it synergizes perfectly with the W build, but yeah, I personally don't like that for the simple reason that you charge it pretty slow in some cases. And Huntress is always good, play that one if you like, but I personally love the E talent the most. And then the 16 talent, the most important one. If you bind a target, then you can build up 5 stacks and then your pull damage will increase by a whole lot. And I can show you how to build up 5 stacks in a 1v1. First of all, you need the Blade Dance talent, that's why I recommend to take that. And yeah, the Blade Dance talent, it adds physical damage to your already magic damage, and it will give you instantly 2 stacks for your 16 talent. I will show it to you. I just did 1 Q and I get 2 stacks. And you need that one to get your 5 stacks, and I will show to you how to do that. First you bind your target, then you do all your stuff, even your E. You need to deal damage with your E and add some auto attacks, and after you get 5 stacks you have to teleport out. That means you have to recast your E, and if you teleport out you will pull your target just in the last moment, and it kinda looks like this. You see here 5 stacks, I teleport out, pull him, add one more auto attack if you can. Here you see a greedy 0-2, he's jumping to me, I'm gonna bind him, do my full combo, build up 5 stacks, teleport out, and he dies. Same thing again, now with Hanzo, he's greedy at me, I build up 5 stacks and bam. And then, if you bind more than one target and deal damage to them, you will instantly get more stacks. You see here, 5 stacks, you see I got 25 stacks, and here enemies around. Look, I'm running, then I'm staying, I'm baiting them, then I'm hiding here in the brush. Then I do my combos, build up 5 stacks and bam, 2 nukes for free. And then let's talk about the next step, the level 7 talent. It adds even more damage to your Q if you reset it once. And if you reset it, it will shine over here. And it will also give you stacks. And of course you have to pull your targets to get value out of the 16 talent. But this is pretty easy to play around. First of all, you sort in the 1v1. I teleported out and he get pulled. But you can also do it like this. If you press your E somewhere else, anywhere you wanna run, then you pull your targets, build up 5 stacks and teleport out. Looks like this. Bam. Look at Greymane and Genji. But you can also do other stuff, but for that you need the level 20 talent. Theoretically I teleport in, then I do my Maiev stuff and teleport out again, and with the second teleport I pull them. And yeah, it looks like this. So you saw 10,000 damage, without stacks, without anything, and I'm pretty sure you can do much more damage. I was just showing it to you. That was already a good combo, but I will show you one more. For that you can combine your Q and your E. And it kinda looks like this. That's it with the guide. I really hope you liked it. And please tell me your thoughts in the comments. Leave a like if you liked that and subscribe if you wanna see more. Blizzard, please don't nerf the W build.